For theoretical multiple choice questions, these points are very important. Coherent sources. And then incoherent sources. Now, what is the coherent source? The two sources of light are said to be coherent if they continuously emit light waves. The two sources are coherent if they continuously emit light waves of same frequency. Of same frequency with zero or constant phase difference between them. Then the sources are said to be coherent if the two sources continuously emit light waves of same frequency with zero, same frequency with zero or constant phase difference between them, then the sources are said to be coherent. Then what is incoherent sources? Do not emit light waves of constant phase difference. Sources do not emit light waves of constant phase difference. So this is the main difference between coherent source and incoherent source. This is the main phase difference between coherent source and incoherent source. Coherent sources can be obtained. Our main interest is coherent sources. They emit light waves of same frequency with zero or constant phase difference between them. Do not emit light waves of constant phase difference. Now see here, coherent sources can be obtained by using following methods. Are obtained by following methods. So which are these methods? You know all this theory part. They are obtained by following methods. Source and its virtual image. Source and its virtual image. By using this way, we can obtain the coherent sources in Lloyd's mirror experiment. In Lloyd's mirror experiment, we obtain the two coherent sources by using Lloyd mirror, and here source and its virtual image acts as a coherent sources. Then second is, two virtual images of same source. Two virtual images of same source are also coherent, and we obtain this in Fresnel's biprism experiment. Fresnel is name of scientist. Fresnel's biprism experiment. Then another way to obtain the coherent sources is two real images of same source. We obtain the two real images of same source इन यंग्स डबल स्लिट एक्सपेरिमेंट, शॉर्टली वी राइट इट एज YDSE. In Young's double slit experiment, we obtain the two coherent sources. That is, the two sources are real images of the same source. Now, there are some necessary conditions for the interference of light. These conditions are also important conditions to get the steady interference pattern or sustain the interference pattern. There are some conditions. If these conditions are satisfied, then we get the steady interference pattern. So, necessary conditions for the interference of light. Necessary conditions for sustained. It is also called as steady. Sustained, it is also called as steady or permanent or stable. Interference pattern. Necessary condition for steady or sustained or permanent or stable interference pattern. There are different conditions to get the steady interference pattern or sustained interference pattern. Main 2-3 conditions are: the sources must be coherent. The two sources must be coherent. We know meaning of the coherent sources. Sources must be coherent. They must have same frequency. These three conditions are very important. There are different conditions. And they must have equal amplitude. Equal amplitude. If these conditions are satisfied, the interference pattern is steady or it is permanent. Or we say that it is a stable interference pattern. And then we see one experiment to perform the to see the interference of light or to study the interference of light. And there are different numericals based on this experiment, or theory numericals are also there on this, based on this experiment. That experiment is Young's double slit experiment. By using this experiment, we can solve theoretical multiple choice question. If you read the theory carefully, and you can also solve the numericals. The experiment is Young's double slit experiment.